Hello, I'm Adam and welcome. Today I will show you how to configure a Octoprint software on any x86 architecture PC. Okay, I'm connected by SSH to my terminal and it's really clean installation of Debian. As proof, you can see it used only 923 megabytes. And there is about half available, and there is a 2 GB disk drive. As you see, I didn't create a swap memory, but why? And now, as we can see, there is a zero memory swap. There is a zero swap memory, but as you can see, I've got installed 1 GB of memory. And there is something like a shared memory to the graphic cards, but this is a terminal and it don't need a graphic card. So I set lowest value, which is 64 megabytes for the graphic. And now we can see there is 60 megabytes of RAM used. So it won't be much bigger than that. And normally it never should pass the whole memory. So that's why I decided to don't create a swap memory, because I wanted to have a little bit more space for the Octoprint and the G-code files. Okay, so now we are on route and we have to do, as always, apt-get update and upgrade to make sure everything is up to date. And now we have to install Python with some additional libraries, and let's do this. Yes, and now everything is installing. By the way, the hard disk drive is 2 GB, has 2 GB capacity, but how about speeds? And it got 20 megabytes read and 20 megabytes write. You can say that's really low, because for example, every hard disk drive from laptop, even old laptop, should have about 50-50. But there is one thing that makes this drive better than these slow hard disk drives, because it's like SSD. That means it don't have a plate inside, and the access time to memory is way faster than standard drive. So the 20 megabytes is enough. And we can say that in the Raspberry Pi, the older ones, like Raspberry Pi 3, 2, 1 or 0 versions, the SD card speed bandwidth is anyway limited to about 20 megabytes per second. So that's something around same. Okay, it's done, but now, as we can see, we've got only 400 megabytes available. So I have to clean the apt-get cache. To do this, I have to write apt-get clean. And now, yeah, something 160 megabytes. So that's really important. Okay, and since we have installed the Python, we can switch to user Adam, and let's go to home. And now we have to create a folder and go inside this folder. Then we have to write virtualenv. Okay. We are working in virtual environment in Python. I don't know why Octoprint is working like this, but anyway, but whatever. Now we have to write activate. Okay, now we are in console, and now we can check if our version of pip is up to date by upgrading it. Yes, up to date. And install Octoprint. Okay, and it finished. And same as before, it's good to clean a cache because I'm very limited on space. Something like this, yeah. And now to exit this virtual environment, we have to press Ctrl A and D. And now we have to add user to groups that to be sure that he can have access to the serial ports. So we have to write user mod agdy user. What? Okay, so I'm not sure why it. So maybe don't clean a cache if you don't want to make a mess like this. What happened? We don't got a link for the user mode and other comments. So I have to write full path user mode, but you probably should be able to do it with writing just user mode. And yeah, out. Okay. Now we can go to user Adam. And we can see it's home, and now we can use the try to run the Octoprint software. Now we can switch to Chrome browser and let's try at port 5000. It needs time. Oh, and yes. And there we've got the setup wizard. And it's the first configuration of our Octoprint, so we can define an account and password. Yeah, very strong. And keep access enabled because I'm connecting to my printer from everywhere. Anomalous tracking, no thanks. Online activity check, okay. Plugin blacklist, okay. Printer profile, okay, let's. Let's say Hypercube, let's say 300 by 300 by 300, heated bed, okay, axis, whatever, server comments, we don't need that, webcam. Next video will be about connecting a webcam to our Octoprint. And yeah, that's it, finish. Okay, generally now we've got a working Octoprint, but this Octoprint software is not working on a as a service, because I can just close it and it won't work now. Yeah, so we need to define a service. So let's download the files from the Octoprint GitHub. Okay, and okay, and I've got two files, and we have to move those to etc. Okay, and this one. And now we have to give execute permission. Yeah, we need to open default Octoprint. And now we have to change Octoprint user to user the account which you have set. So in my case it's Adam, and you have to set a daemon uncommented, and you have to set a correct path so the Octoprint is located in Adam folder. And okay, Control X to save, Y to yes, and enter to save. And now we have to update. And now the Octoprint started as a service in background. And now we can see how much we are using memory. And we can see it got 120 megabytes of memory usage. And the Octoprint will be ready in a second. Yeah, reload. And okay, so now I should be able to connect to my 3D printer. Let's see. And yeah, I'm connected. Yes, we can see there is a temperature and terminal. Yeah, so it got connected without any problems. That's great. And it's worth to look. Oh, and by the way, yeah, we've got 450 megabytes of memory, which is pretty good for the only G-codes. Okay, and it's important to look on the plugins for Octoprint. And we can go to Plugin Manager, and that's everything installed. Get more. There are so many great plugins, and like Detailed Progress or some filters to terminal because it's spamming. Two changes take effect. We have to restart our Octoprint. So let's service. Let's make service restart. Okay. Wow. And we can see something changed, and I like this because it may be more accurate than this. I will see. Oh, there is something too added. Yeah, I like it. And that's it for this time. The next video will be about configuring a motion. So yeah, Thank you for watching. Please leave a comment and hit the subscribe button. Bye.